Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's explore how one can study the metabolic activity of a molecule that is being considered as a possible lead or drug. In the later stages of lead optimization, a lead may be tested in animals, in vivo testing. Plasma drawn from the animal can give information on plasma concentration in the molecule, the half-life, volume of distribution, and clearance, and even the identity of different metabolites. This is great information, but studies in animals are very expensive and time-consuming. There are also ethical considerations for animal testing. Drug discovery programs involve the creation of assays to test molecules for potency and efficacy. Are there assays that can test metabolism? Absolutely. Metabolic assays are normally split into two categories, microsomal and hepatocyte assays. Microsomal assays involve membranes from within liver cells. The specific assay is often listed as HLM, human liver microsomes. Proteins found within these membranes are responsible for the phase one metabolic reactions. These are the oxidations, the reductions, and hydrolysis reactions. Microsomal assays often look at the rate of disappearance of a lead compound over a period of time. It's also possible to analyze the assay medium to identify specific metabolites formed. Hepatocyte assays are similar but involve whole, intact liver cells. Hepatocytes. In addition to phase one reactions, hepatocyte assays also allow monitoring of phase two reactions, the phase two conjugations. Being cellular assays, hepatocyte assays are slightly more difficult and expensive to perform. The stability data from these assays are useful predicting a molecule's clearance in the form of intrinsic clearance, CLINT. CLINT has units of milliliters per minute. Note that CLINT is a prediction that is very useful for making additional predictions, namely the human half-life of a metabolite and hepatic clearance. As a prediction, CLINT is subject to having error. If the molecule in the assay is advanced for testing in animals, PK data from the animal studies will provide additional predictive value. Confirmation of the in vitro and animal data will not occur unless the lead is tested in humans. Note that human PK data tend to be very noisy because expression levels of the metabolic enzymes do vary from one human test subject to another. I hope you found this video worth your time. Please consider subscribing or liking the video. If there's something you do not understand, please leave a question in the comment section below. Take care.